Good morning, and welcome to Florida National Cemetery for our annual Memorial Day ceremony. My name is Gerard Lyons, Assistant Director at Florida National. Sadly, this year, due to the circumstances happening right now in our nation and around the world, you are unable to be here with us live, but we are pleased to be able to honor and remember our veterans today virtually, lest we never forget. I would now like to introduce Mr. Roberto Pizarro, also an assistant director here at Florida National, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by Mrs. Dawn DeNome singing our national anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, Roberto and Don. I would now like to introduce Chaplain Felix Ramirez, a member of the Joint Veterans Support Committee at Florida National Cemetery, for our invocation.
Good morning, let us pray. Creator God, I come before you today to give you honor and praise. You are worthy, Lord. I worship you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for reminding us that freedom is not free. Heavenly Father, you are the source of our healing. You are the source of all of our blessings. Thank you for helping our hearts to heal. Help the parents, spouses, and children, and friends who are hurting today and every day for the loss of the loved ones who are buried here. Heavenly Father, please continue blessing and protecting them. Lord, please be with our soldiers who are in harm's way at this moment. I thank you for this opportunity you've given me to come and gather together this day with my family and my friends. We ask you to guide and direct this service so that it is full of wisdom and respect for our soldiers. Creator God, thank you for helping us to accomplish our respect and honor for our fallen heroes. Today, we honor and we remember them. In Jesus' name I pray. And praise you. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Ramirez. We are now honored to have Mr. Daniel McLean play Amazing Grace on the bagpipes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Daniel. We are honored and blessed today to have someone very special to Florida National Cemetery as our keynote speaker, retired Major General James S. Hammer Hartzell. Retired Marine Corps Major General James S. Hammer Hartzell is the current Deputy Executive Director of the Florida Department of Veterans Affairs. The agency operates a network of seven states' veterans homes and provides statewide outreach to connect Florida's more than 1.5 million veterans with their earned services, benefits, and support. He was appointed to his present position in April of 2019. Major General Hartzell is also a member of the Florida National Cemetery Joint Veterans Support Committee. Major General Hartzell served as an enlisted Marine in the reserves from 1981 to 1983 and was commissioned as an officer serving on active duty from 1983 to 1994. He then transitioned to the reserves where he was mobilized for Operations Iraqi Freedom in 2003 and Iraqi Freedom II in 2004, and Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan in 2009 to 2010. In 2018, he completed 37 years of faithful military service to our nation. The General's awards and decorations include the Defense Superior Service Medal, Legion of Merit, Bronze Star, and Combat Action Ribbons for combat in both Iraq and Afghanistan. He's also a Marine Corps Distinguished Pistol Shooter. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to introduce retired Major General James S. Hammer Hartzell.
Good morning. I'm both deeply humbled and sincerely honored to be given the opportunity to participate in this year's Memorial Day service. The current COVID-19 pandemic has affected all of us in so many ways, but one thing it cannot affect is our heartfelt desire and our determination to pay honors and tribute to those who have given the ultimate sacrifice for our nation. Great Americans, of whom it truly can be said that those who served in our military gave more in their lifetime to our nation than they ever took from it. Those of us who've had the privilege to serve in our nation's defense can understand that our United States of America is an exceptional nation, a nation blessed by God, a nation among the global community that has both the ability and at times the need to maintain both security and stability whenever and wherever it best serves our national interest. 1 week from today will be the 39th anniversary of when I took my oath of enlistment and answered the call to do my part in standing time on the wall of our nation's defense. 39 years ago, I voluntarily raised my right hand, and I pledged to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. And over those many 39 years, I've had the great privilege to speak to groups all across our nation and around the world. But I feel especially privileged to answer the Florida National Cemetery leadership's team call to duty to participate in this Memorial Day ceremony here with you all today. Right now, all across our nation, we, as well as many family and friends of our past veterans, are thinking about and remembering loved ones who have served. Bonds were formed between those of us who are blessed to have shared a life with those that we memorialize today. Whether that time was shared at a home, or at a duty station, or in a foxhole, or on a deployment together, regardless of the location, or the amount of time we spent with those we honor today, deep life bonds were formed. Bonds and memories that neither time, nor age, nor even COVID-19 will ever allow to be diminished or forgotten. It's my long-held belief that Memorial Day should be one of our nation's most solemn and also most patriotic days. It's a day when all Americans, regardless of ideologies, race, creed, or political persuasions, collectively, we all remember and memorialize the lives and the sacrifices of those who answered the call to serve in the defense of our nation. Sadly, the significance of this day is often confused and distorted by many who don't fully appreciate or understand the true meaning of what our nation has set this day aside for. I truly believe that if all Americans fully recognized and fully appreciated the meaning of this Memorial Day, they'd be better citizens of our nation and able to take more pride in our great United States of America and what it has stood for over the past 245 years since our founding fathers created our more perfect union. Memorial Day is a time for us to reflect on the past, to take stock of the present, and to renew our commitment to the future of America's continued freedoms and the liberties that we enjoy. Our precious gift of freedom is fragile, and we should never forget how precious and costly it has been and continues to be to maintain. Many around the world dream of and hope for the types of freedom, liberty, equality, justice, and economic opportunities that we Americans enjoy. In these current, highly distressed times that our nation is experiencing, many of our citizens are frustrated. They're discouraged. Many are downright angry at where they feel our nation is today and where it may be headed in the future. Many of our citizens are genuinely concerned with the current status of our republic and of the potential degradation of the freedoms and liberties we all enjoy. I personally have a grave concern for the ever-increasing moral decay that I feel is eroding the very foundation of who and what America is and what it was founded to be. And while it's true that we Americans have plenty to be concerned and worried about today, I want you all to know and appreciate there is still no place on earth where a nation's citizens have more freedoms or more liberties than we have right here in the United States. I've been blessed to have visited over 50 countries around the world, and I can personally attest that America is still the best place to live and is still the greatest nation on earth. And especially on this Memorial Day, I want us all to remember that it's largely because of those who are honoring today that we are the greatest nation on earth. My liberty, your liberty, and the continued hope of liberty for our generations to come was paid for by the personal sacrifice of our military veterans' liberties. We must never forget that liberty and freedom that we enjoy in our nation never has been or ever will be free. It's been bought and paid for by the brave Americans that we honor on this Memorial Day. Our American veterans each paid a price by serving tours of duty filled with sacrifice for both self and for their families, and for some, with the ultimate sacrifice, their very lives. In whatever way these veterans paid, whether in peacetime or in wartime, they all answered the call to step up and be prepared to confront our nation's enemies. Enemies who in the past and still to this very day seek to do us harm and to restrict our American way of life, our liberty, and our pursuit of our happiness. President Ronald Reagan once said, "No arsenal and no weapon in the arsenals of the world is so formidable as the will and the moral courage of free men and women." As long as we have men and women in America who have the will and moral courage to answer the call to serve and to defend our nation, we will continue to be the land of the free, a land envied by all others, a land where our citizens know that our lives, our liberties, and our pursuits of happiness are both protected and assured. America has been the land of the free for 245 years because it's been the land of the brave veterans that we honor here today for all those 245 years. Several years ago, a fellow veteran gave me a sticker that read, "A veteran is someone who at one point in their life wrote a blank check made payable to the United States of America for an amount up to and including their life." As I reflected on the meaning of that statement, my heart and my mind were drawn back to a time where I personally learned the true meaning of what that statement's words meant. That time was 10 years ago when I deployed to Afghanistan for a 13-month tour where one of my duties was to preside as the senior Marine officer over the ramp ceremonies where we honored our fallen warriors who were returning and being sent home on military air flights back to their loved ones for internment. Regardless of the time of day or night, everyone who could would voluntarily assemble as a solemn honor guard on the airfield by forming two long silent ranks facing each other at silent attention while Amazing Grace was being played on bagpipes, while the fallen Marine or sailor's flag-draped casket was being carried by their brothers in arms up into the aircraft to carry them on their final ride home. My Sergeant Major and I were the last ones to kneel over the flag-draped caskets as taps was being played while the aircraft's ramp was being closed. When I would hear taps being played during those ceremonies, I'd always think of the fallen's family and of their pain and sadness they must be feeling over the loss of their loved one. And I would reflect on both my own and the fallen's family's deep feeling of remorse over the unfinished life of their loved one, a life that had ended at such a young age and so far away from home. One comfort that I could feel, though, at those times was knowing that their sacrifice had been tied to an act of selflessness for their brothers in arms, And that's when I began to find comfort in the understanding that the true completeness of a life should never be measured by how many years someone had lived. That it be, but more appropriately, it should be measured by their deeds, their valor, and the sacrifices they had made for others while they lived. That's what truly had given that person's life its purpose, while they lived, no matter how many years that had been. In our brigade's battle headquarters in Afghanistan, we created a wall of remembrance with pictures and names of every one of our Marines and sailors who had fallen on the field of battle while we were there. In the middle of that wall was a plaque, and it read, "All gave some, but some gave all." One of the fallen Marines for whom I performed a ramp ceremony in Afghanistan 10 years ago is buried right here in Florida National Cemetery. And those of us who had the privilege to serve with these heroes, we will never forget their personal sacrifice for the rest of us, that we may be alive today and that we may live free. For all who have lost a loved one who served in our nation's military, whether in recent times or in times past, I want you to know that your veteran is honored and remembered here today by us and by a grateful nation. I also want to ask everyone to please make an effort at some point today to think about and to pray for those who are still serving in our nation's military. We owe all of our nation's military, both past and present, the highest respect and honor. And it's our responsibility as citizens of our nation to reassure them that their current commitment to the defense of our nation and for our continued freedoms is not forgotten and will never be taken for granted. In closing, I leave you with the words spoken 2,500 years ago by the King of Sparta as he stood with his 300 warriors in a place called Thermopylae. King Leonidas knew that he and his men would not survive their battle against the overwhelming numbers of Persians that they faced, and he knew they would not be returning home to their loved ones. So he chose one soldier to take a very solemn message back home to Sparta. I feel that his message and its meaning are both fitting and appropriate for us to reflect on here today as we remember and pay our solemn tribute to our nation's veterans who've gone on before us. King Leonidas said, "When you get home, tell them of us and tell them for their tomorrow, we gave our today." Thank you for letting me speak with you all here today. To my Marine brothers and sisters, Semper Fidelis, and may God continue to bless our great state of Florida and our great United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you, Major General Hartzell. We would now like to welcome back Mrs. Dawn DeNome to perform a medley of America the Beautiful and God Bless America.
Beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of gray. For purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed His grace on thee and crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. America, land that I love, stand
beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white.
Thank you, Don. Major General Hartzell will now present a wreath at the gravesite of Army Specialist Eric Ramirez, son of Chaplain Ramirez. Major General Hartzell will be joined by Gerard Tiberius Lyons and Tracy Ramirez, Eric's wife. At the age of 31, Eric was killed while on patrol about 30 miles west of Baghdad before dawn on February 24, 2004. When his California National Guard unit was attacked by small arms, rocket-propelled grenades, and homemade explosive devices. Eric was just 6 weeks away from returning home to his wife and newborn son. As our ceremony comes to a close, Mr. David Sahara, United States Navy, retired Senior Chief Petty Officer, will play taps. Thank you, Mr. Sahara, for your service to our country and your support of Florida National Cemetery. I'd like to now welcome back Chaplain Ramirez for our benediction.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for helping us pay tribute to our heroes. Bless all who are present here today. And as we remember those who lived and died to preserve our liberty and our freedom in our nation and in this world, Creator God, I ask you to remember all those whose sacrifice gave this nation its greatness, its progress, and its freedom. May our memory and all of those who served in the armed forces be an honorable one, full of thanksgiving to you, Lord, and help us continue to remember with much love those who died in the service of our country, whether on the air or on the land or on the sea. May your strength, Heavenly Father, sustain us. May your power of you, God, preserve us. May your hands, Creator God, protect us. May your way, God, direct us. May your love, God, go with us this day and forever. Be with us and provide us with traveling mercy as we return to our homes. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. The Lord lift up his countenance upon us and give us peace this day and forevermore. In the precious name of Jesus, I pray and praise you. Amen.
On behalf of our executive director, Mr. Tony Thomas, the entire staff and volunteers at Florida National Cemetery, we would like to thank you for joining us in honoring and remembering our veterans laid to rest here and all around the nation. We pray that you are safe and well during this difficult time in our nation. Thank you for joining us today, and God bless the United States of America.